Hi guys, welcome to my 100 subscriber Q&A. Got a bunch of questions here on the laptop that people have left on the 100 subscriber video. Everyone who's left a comment who wishes to be entered will be entered into the chance to win a PS2 bundle. So we got a load of questions, some good, really good questions here. So I'll start at the bottom and work my way up. So first question is from Underwater Level. Congrats on the 100 subscribers. Thank you. What is the most amount of games you own for any one console? That's definitely PlayStation 2. It's 250 something. It was quite a way over 400 games, but I just sold off about 150, so it's just over 250. And imagine Dreamcast will overtake that shortly. Maybe by the end of the year. So yeah, thanks Underwater Level and good luck. Next question is from the Highlander. Do you think there could ever be an event in the UK organised completely by YouTubers which could rival the retro events we have today? And what would such an event have to have? I mean, I don't see why not. I don't see why it being organised by YouTubers would be any different from it being organised by anyone else, really. I think that if it was just a YouTuber's event, it would be very small. But organised by them, why not? Yeah, and I mean, I think an event to be successful would have to be a proper retro event. So many of these retro events now are steering more towards mainstream gaming and modern gaming and other things, like Play Manchester, which is becoming more and more focused on other things, like they have the film and movie props and stuff there now. They have signings by actors there, and then they have all the modern gaming and all this and that. But I think if it was to be a successful retro event, it would have to be proper retro. I think is the answer to that question. So good luck, the Highlander. Cheers for the question. Next question is from LGG. What's your favourite genre of game and why? Now, like I said on the 100 sub video, I just can't answer questions like what's your favourite this, that and the other. So there's no way I can answer that. I just couldn't pick a genre of game that I like the most. I just couldn't. I like so many different genres. I like RPGs, strategy, action adventure, driving games. I like side-scrolling beat-em-ups, I like versus beat-em-ups. I like all sorts. I could tell you what it's not, and that's sports games, but that's the best I can do, I'm afraid, mate, but good luck. Next one is from Paweł Rosły, and the question is in Polish, which I'll try to read, because I don't read as well as I speak it, so. Gratuluję, Pete, so congratulations, Pete. A moje pytanie, my question, jaka będzie następna konsola z pełną biblioteką gier? How will be the next console with full library of games? So what will be your next console that you'll be doing the full library of? So I'll answer that in Polish and I'll put subtitles down for the rest of you guys. Paweł, później Sega Dreamcast 100% nic, kurwa, ponieważ nie mam, nie trzeba mi atak serca, kurwa, rozumiesz? Dzięki. Okay, so that's the answer to that question, so cheers Paweł for the question. Next is from Online Retro, which would you give up, Dreamcast or your arcade cab? That's like a torturous question, isn't it? It's horrible. I think, you know, looking at it realistically and logically, it would be the arcade cab, because I have somewhere a little MAME disc for the Dreamcast that has most of those games on anyway. So the thing with the Dreamcast is the emulation's not great for it. You can't really play the games anywhere but on the Dreamcast, whereas I can play arcade games on the Dreamcast, so I guess it would be I'd give up my arcade cab. So thanks for the question, Online Retro. Next is Infected Flinch, who has asked a series of questions. If there was ever a good smell you could smear yourself in, what would it be? I really don't know. Oh God, what smells good? Jesus, what a question. I don't know, mint's pretty nice, isn't it? I do like the smell of mint. Whenever I smell fresh mint, it reminds me of the garden when I was a kid, because we used to have mint in the garden. Or coconut's nice. I don't know, mate. Have you attempted to touch a hedgehog? No. What was the game that made you realise you were a gamer? Oh, God. That's got... I mean, we're going back now, because I think pretty much... As soon as I encountered games, I was, you know, in love with them. So we're either going back to the NES, and the first game I would have played would have been something like Duck Hunt or Mario or Mega Man or Super Spike Volleyball, or it would be the BBC Micro. So, you know, probably the earliest memory I have is playing Striker's Run on the BBC Micro. I'm not sure if I played something before that, but I do remember playing that, and I used to play that relentlessly just to get that little bit further, that little bit further. So it's probably either that or it's the Donkey Kong Game & Watch, which is up there. Because I had that in the very early 80s, and that was one of the... Well, in fact, that was the first gaming thing that I owned, so it was probably that, to be honest. So next question is, you don't want anybody else, whenever you think of me, do you touch yourself? Extra points if you know the reference. Of course I know the reference. It's I Touch Myself by the Divinyls. So the answer to that is yes, Dave, I do not want anybody else. When I think about you, I touch myself. Whoa. Next question is, if you could find a person to blame for cancelling PT, the Silent Hills demo, who would you blame most? I would blame you, Dave. So yeah, cheers for the questions. Good luck. Next one is Matthew Martley. Matt. So, somebody sells you a dodgy time machine which only works in one direction. You can either travel into the future or into the past, but not both. You can pick which direction you want to travel in, but then the machine is locked in that direction forever. You can return to the present time from both directions, but can only travel into the direction of your choice. Which do you choose and why? It would be the past, for sure. There's no guarantee. You could travel a year into the future and a meteor could have hit the Earth and it could be completely mullered. So I think definitely travel into the past, and travel through history is always something that I think appeals to most people, for sure. So it would definitely be the past. And Matt has written another little question. Also, what's your favourite form of pasta? Oh. So we've got another favourite question here. My brain's already like shutting down. Oh man, I like linguine. I love ravioli. Tortellini. Nah, I can't do it. I can't do it, Matt, sorry. No idea, pasta's just all too good to pick a favourite. Right, next question is from Hugh Stewart. Have you ever told a shop or a vendor that their prices are too high? You're damn right I have, of course. I don't think there's anything wrong with telling people their prices are too high. I do it in charity shops all the time. I go in, where did I go in the other day? RSPCA. And they had Xbox games, original Xbox games, and like shit games that were worth like 50p, and they were 20 quid. And I said, look, you know, I'm not interested in Xbox anyway, but just a heads up, you're not going to sell those. Even for a quid, people are probably and ah over them. For 20 quid, you know, you've got no chance. I don't know who's doing your pricing. But yeah, I'll do it. I'll do it in places. Especially if I want to haggle, I'm all up for haggling, and if people don't want to come down, then that's up to them, isn't it? So, yeah, for definite, I've told people their prices are too high is the answer to that. So thanks for the question. Good luck. Right, next question is from Lucy, Retro Gaming Girl. Congrats on 100 subscribers, Pete. Thanks, Lucy. My question is, what is your top three Dreamcast games? Is that okay to ask? Yes, that is okay to ask. It will probably be the top three that I can think of off the top of my head. And I think I'll pick three games that aren't available on any other system, really. Because there's a lot of great games, but you can find them elsewhere. So I won't include Shenmue because I think that would be a bit off-putting for a lot of people because it's so in-depth, but I mean, I could put it in. It is, you know, a fantastic game. It's Shenmue is definitely in there, actually. Because it's a top three games for me rather than anyone else. So it's definitely Shenmue, amazing game. When I first played that, it actually absolutely blew me away and subsequently spent about 5 solid days playing it. Zero Gunner 2 definitely is one of my favourite games on the system, absolutely love that game. And then I would say, Power Stone 2, maybe, which is fantastic game. You can't get it anywhere else. It is available in the Power Stone collection on PSP, which is like a conversion of the Dreamcast version, but yeah, fantastic game. So that's the answer to that. Good luck, Lucy. Right, Kevin Wolford 123. Have you ever smelled your brand new game boxes, or am I just weird for doing it? Of course I have. No, you're not weird for doing it. I'm sure everybody does it. It's the same with anything new car or new this, that and the other, and you smell it. And new games, for sure, yeah, smell them, why not? I smell everything. I smell everything before I eat it, and, you know, why not? So cheers for your question, Kevin, and good luck. Next question is from Round 2 Gaming Channel. Thanks for putting together this giveaway, and a huge well-deserved congrats on 100 subs. Thank you. I have a Dreamcast with tons of games, but embarrassingly have never played it. My question would be, in your opinion, what are the first three games that I should play that show off the capabilities, controls, uniqueness of the console? So that, I mean, the first three games I would say to play is, I think the shooters would be a toss-up between Zero Gunner 2 and Stormwind, because Stormwind just looks fantastic, but I'll try and stick to one per genre. So my first one would be Zero Gunner 2, because I just love that game, and it looks great. The next game would be, I'd say Power Stone 2, actually, because it's a really quirky game, really good fun, and it's console exclusive. And thirdly, it would either be Cannon Spike or Jet Set Radio, probably. I'd say Jet Set Radio, really great game, and really unique, but yeah, great music, great game. It really shows the kind of vibe of the Dreamcast, I think, and the kind of vibe that Sega had during that time. So I definitely recommend those three. So thanks for the question, good luck. Next question is from Craig Minx36. I think it was your 100th sub, Pete. Nice prize to give away that, mate. I don't want to be entered into the giveaway though, as I don't need it, so it would be a waste if I was lucky enough to win. So good luck to everybody else. So thanks, Craig, and thanks for your comment. Next question is from 1T, Matropolis. Congrats on the subs. Cheers, Matt. Judging by the background music, you may be a fan of the Monkey Island series. So in my 100 sub video, I had a bit of Monkey Island music. Which of the games is your favourite? And would you like to see The Curse of Monkey Island release on current gen consoles as the first two were? Now, I'm a massive fan of Monkey Island. One of my favourite games, absolutely, the first two games. My favourite in the series would definitely be number 2. I love number 1, but number 2 is just a masterpiece. It's such a step up graphically. It's hilarious, it's huge, it's such good fun, and I know the story and I know the game like the back of my hand, and it's something that I'll go through and complete quite often, and it just never gets old. It's just fantastic. So it's definitely Monkey Island 2, LeChuck's Revenge. And would I like to see the Curse of Monkey Island release current gen? Not that bothered really. I only really got into the first two. I have played through the Curse and the one after that. What's that? Escape from Monkey Island. But I'm not that much of a fan of them. I'd love to see Dave Grossman and Tim Schafer team up and do a proper Monkey Island 3, which I know they'd love to do. But seeing as now Disney own the rights, having bought Lucasfilm, I think it's slim chance really. But yeah, thanks for your question, Matt. And we've got Amiga Old School is going to ask the same question, but doesn't want to be entered into the competition. So cheers, guys, and good luck, Matt. Next question is from Monkey Spaz 5000. Red, blue, green, Tuesday sauce, Thursday sauce, your thoughts? No idea what you're on about, mate, but I do like sauce. Love sauce, hollandaise, béarnaise, barbecue. Yeah, big fan of sauce, but no idea what you're banging on about, but good luck, mate. Next question is from Peter Dickinson. What series do you think should never have been made? I don't really. I think any bad series is good for the industry anyway, really. I think that you need the bad and the good, and I don't think anything that's come out that's bad has been really, really detrimental to the industry, really. So that's all that matters, really. So good luck, Peter. Next question from RetroShocker180. Congrats on the 100 subs, mate. Fully deserved. Great channel. Thank you very much. Very kind. What was the first console you owned and the first game you remember playing? So this is kind of going back to thinking about the BBC Micro. So I think, yeah, the first game I remember playing, which might not have been the first, but the first one I remember was Strikers Run on the BBC Micro, and the Game & Watch, Donkey Kong Game & Watch. I think that's probably the first game I remember playing, but the first console I owned was either the Mega Drive or the Game Boy. I can't remember which I got first. I got a feeling I got the Game Boy first and then the Mega Drive shortly after, but we did have an Amiga already in the house, but I guess that doesn't count as a console. So I hope that answers your question, so good luck. Next question from Loch Ness Monster. Who or what made you decide to start your channel? It's a great question. I think it was several people, just people who I've watched. Before I made this channel, I had another channel that I used to watch my subs on, and I had a lot of game collectors on there. People like Tootie and Rich King Retro, Ninja Bear Hug, just watching people collecting games. And I just started this channel really because this is like my chance to just talk to you guys about the retro games that I pick up and that I own, because I don't have any other outlet for that. I can't bore my mates to death because they're interested in gaming, but they're not particularly interested in collecting and, you know, in the mentality that this community has. It's very different from people who just play games. So I do talk to my friends about gaming and like modern gaming, but yeah, this is kind of my outlet for talking about my passion and my hobby, really. So that's why I started it, and it's been great for that. I mean, it's been everything I hoped for in that respect and more, really. So yeah, great question. Thanks for the question, and good luck. Next one is Soulfrank Retro. Well done on reaching 100 subscribers, buddy. Ace competition, thank you. I have 4 PS2s, so I'll leave the prize winning to someone else, if that's okay. To everyone else, good luck. So cheers for that, Matt, Soulfrank Retro. Next question is Steve Addy Sneaker Freak. What a lovely prize, Pete. Okay, my question. If you were marooned on a desert island with nothing but a Dreamcast and Holly Valance, or however you, I think she's the one from, was in Neighbours or something? Anyway, yeah, if you're marooned on a desert island with nothing but a Dreamcast and Holly Valance, in your spare time away from Holly, what three games would you choose to take with you? Oh man, that is really hard. It's tough because I'm tempted to take a couple of RPGs because they'll get me the most money's worth. But then there's a few I haven't played. Maybe Skies of Arcadia I'd take. Yeah, do you know what? I think I'd just take, to be honest, I'd just take RPGs because I could take shooters or beat-em-ups and they'd just get tired really quickly. If I'm stuck on a desert island, I want some games that I'm going to get a lot of time out of. So I guess I'd take Shenmue, Skies of Arcadia, and maybe I'd take Evolution. Because I'll get a lot of time out of those, to be honest. So yeah, cheers for your question, Steve. Good luck. Next is Champion2D Rob. Congrats on 100 subs, or 100, Pete. Well deserved, mate. So cheers, Rob. I'm not sure if you want to be in the competition, but I'll stick your name in the hat anyway. Right, next question is from Sega CD Universe. Congrats, man. What's your favourite FMV game? So thank you, and my favourite FMV game is probably Dragon's Lair. When I first saw Dragon's Lair, it was amazing. I used to play at the arcade. And I love the, is it Don Bluth who does the animation? He did some cool films, like I think he did that All Dogs Go to Heaven, so it's kind of similar graphical style. But yeah, that was awesome, that game. It was really, really balls hard though. So yeah, cheers for your question, good luck. Next one is from Chris Novabug. What is 42 the answer of? Isn't that What's the Meaning of Life from Hitchhiker's Guide? Do you use buses, and what's your opinion on the drivers? No, I don't really use buses, to be honest. I'll avoid them whenever I can. I kind of avoid public transport in general whenever I can. And obviously I think the drivers are all complete arseholes. Boiled, fried, scrambled or poached? Just kidding, Chris. I think because I'm not a massive fan of the white when they're boiled or fried or poached, but I do like them. But I'd say scrambled is my favourite. If scrambled egg is done properly, it's bloody good, isn't it? So yeah, congrats on the milestone, bud. So cheers, Chris. Good luck. Next is from Razmataz Raz. Question: you ever been over here? And if not, when are you coming? Leave me out of the entries, mate. Leave it to someone else. So yeah, cheers for the question, Raz. I've never been to Sweden. If any of you are watching who don't know Raz, he lives in Sweden. And no, I've never been. But yeah, when am I coming? Well, hopefully soon. Let's have a little chat about that. Why don't we? So yeah, cheers, Raz. Next is from Steve, 36207. Great competition, buddy. No need to enter me as Dad. Cojones Deloro sorted me out with a PS2 and games. So good old Daz. So yeah, cheers anyway for the question. What's one thing you would really like to have in your collection? Could be anything. For me, it would be a sit-down Star Wars cab. Whoa, jeez. I think it would be if I could have like a decent MVS cab with a few slots, full size cab, that would definitely be something that would appeal. Oh, it's a tough one. Yeah, I think that would be it. I'd love space for a full size cab, and I'd love an MVS cab for sure. So I think that would be my answer to that question. So cheers for the question, Steve. Next from Chris Ashanked. What are your best tips for new starters to collecting in terms of how to get collections going? A really good question. I think the most important thing is to not go crazy and just think about it. Think about what you want to do, what you want to achieve. It's all too easy to start collecting and just go mental and buy up everything in sight and just spend a fortune. But I think it's, you focus on a couple of consoles, maybe at a time, that you want to focus on. Work out what games you want for them, and then just go from there, and just be patient. I wait ages for games. There's games that I pick up and I do videos for and I think, oh, I've been off that 5 years. But because I just don't want to go out, I could go out on eBay now and I could buy that game for 20 quid. But I'd rather wait and I'd get it cheaper, I'd buy it for a tenner or I'd buy it for a 50p a quid at the boot sale. You've got to be patient, you can't just go mental. So I think that's my advice, is just to take your time and think about it rather than just jump in. So cheers for crushing, Chris, good luck. Next question from Bad Fuck Up UK, Tim. Do you have such a thing as a Grail console? One that you hope to get one day? For me, it's the FM Towns. I think it would be the Neo Geo AES, to be honest, because it's always something I've coveted and just never bothered to jump in and spend the money on. Obviously, the games are crazy prices, so I think it would definitely be the Neo Geo AES. So cheers, Tim, for your question. Good luck. Next question is Woolly Weeble Duncan. Can you remember the first gaming item you bought from a boot sale? No need to put my name in the comp, I've never been a PlayStation person. So no problem, Duncan, I will not put you in, but thanks for the question. First gaming item I bought from a boot sale, no chance I remember that. I mean, we're going back probably at least 15, 20 years. There's no chance, I wouldn't even have a clue what kind of thing it was. No, I've got no chance, I'm afraid. Sorry, Duncan. Next question is from Glenn Station. What's your favourite game? No, just kidding. What's some of the games you think are overrated? Like, for example, Ocarina of Time is heavily overrated. Yeah, I said it, lol. So yeah, cheers, Glenn, for the question. I actually agree that Ocarina of Time is massively overrated. I'm a much bigger fan anyway of the 2D Zeldas, but yeah, it's a great game, but I can't see why so many people say, like, oh, it's my favourite game, it's my favourite Zelda game. I just don't get it. I just don't really get what's the appeal of it. I'm not denying it's a great game or anything. Same with the Metal Gear Solid series, I think is overrated, but maybe that's just my personal preference. People seem to love it, I just never really got why it's so loved. But I guess I'm not really a big fan of stealthy stuff. What other series are overrated? I don't know really, I think that's all I can think of. FIFA is, I suppose, if you like football games, it's alright, but everyone seems to love it and I don't get it. And Call of Duty is hugely overrated, but then I don't really play online so much. I don't play, you know, I'll buy the game and I'll play through a story for 2 hours and I'll put it on the shelf. But I think they're definitely overrated. So yeah, cheers Glenn for the question and good luck. Next question is from Carl, Darth Twin Rover. Great giveaway there, mate, and congrats on 100 subs. Cheers. This question is not an entry question, but would you like to see Shenmue 3 released and released ever, and if so, which systems? Right, where was I? Sorry, I had to get a cough streak, my throat's so sore. Shenmue 3. Right, I'd love to see Shenmue 3 released. But obviously I'd want to see it be successful, so I think the only way that's going to happen is if it's cross-platform, so Xbox One, PS4, PC. I'd think it would have to be released across the board for it to be successful. I wouldn't want to see it on Dreamcast or anything with old hardware, because it just wouldn't make the money. Looking at Shenmue costing about whatever it was, 70 million back then, you're never going to make your money back on consoles like the Dreamcast or any older consoles. But I would like to see HD remakes of the first two as well. Now, since Carl asked this question, there's been all this hoo-ha about Shenmue 3 and the first two games being released as an HD remake because of some leaked image. So we'll see at E3. I'm sure it'll be the same as it always is whenever there's a Shenmue rumour and we get to E3 and there's nothing. and everybody's, you know, heartbroken, but you never know. We'll see at E3, are they going to release, I think it's more likely to be HD remakes of the first two than it is to be Shenmue 3, but you never know. Maybe they're going to test the water. They're going to release the first two, test the water, see how into it people are, and then think about a third one. I don't know, but yeah, of course I'd like to see Shenmue 3, and I know you would, Carl. So yeah, cheers for the question. Next question, from Dave. I'm a game geek. Well done, Pete, on 100 subs, mate. Nice prize for the winner. Apart from the Dreamcast, what other consoles have a lot of nostalgia? Dave messaged me on Facebook. He doesn't want to be entered into the competition. But yeah, cheers for your question, Dave. So definitely Mega Drive. Well, Dreamcast, obviously, I was about 20 years old. I would have been 18 when Dreamcast came out, but I was probably about 19 when we had one, when I lived with a few mates and my mate had one. But you know, the most nostalgia I have is for the first systems I had in the house. So the Amiga 500, and I had concurrently with that a Mega Drive and a Nintendo Game Boy. So definitely the consoles I have the most fond memories for, definitely the Mega Drive and the Game Boy. Playing Streets of Rage 2, playing Toe Jam and Earl, Kid Chameleon, playing Zelda Link's Awakening on the Game Boy, Mario 1 and 2, Tetris, and yeah, the Amiga 500, just absolutely my favourite gaming system of all time. It's just fantastic, and I, you know, really, really cut my teeth getting into gaming properly on the Amiga 500. So yeah, that's the answer to that. Cheers, Dave. Next question is from Pat. Any old username? What is your most prized possession and why? I don't know, really. Do I prize anything particularly? Not really, you know. Apart from my cat. Nothing I own can't be replaced, so I don't think there's anything in particular that I particularly prize. Sorry, Pat, if that doesn't answer your question, but there you go. Good luck, mate. Looks like the last question is from Russ Newton. Congratulations, Pete, on the 100 subs. Cheers, Russ. You have free time. Do you play some Dreamcast and relax or make a video? How do you manage your free time? And I was saying that that's a question that I really wonder about a lot of people. Look, you know, you're working full time, you've got other things to do in your free time, and you have to make time to make videos. So, I mean, videos don't take long. I mean, it probably takes half an hour to record this video, and then it won't take long to edit it and just add a bit of music on. So, I mean, most of the free time, I don't really get much gaming done, to be honest. I haven't played my PS3 for about 4 months. I put Beyond Two Souls in my PS3 about 4 months ago. I still haven't played it, so I mean, that's at least 4 months since I played the PS3. And I've played a bit of Dreamcast and some Mega Drive and Saturn, really, lately. But a bit of SNES. But yeah, I mean, just bits here and there, just grab them when I can. I don't have that much time for gaming, really, at the moment. Which I'm trying to sort. I mean, I do work a second job at the moment, you know, not many hours a week, but I think soon when I maybe leave that, I'll have a bit more time. But yeah, I mean, generally in my free time, it's more just chilling with the missus and watch TV or whatever and try and see my mates when I can. But yeah, it's difficult. It's really difficult. Sometimes it's just a case of, you know, Mrs. goes to bed quite early, so I could game, or lately I've been doing quite a bit of Photoshop stuff, and I sit in front of the TV and do a bit of Photoshop or whatever. But yeah, I mean, you know, that's just one of those things, really. But I want to get back into PS3, really, and I want to look at getting a PS4 shortly, so I think I'll be doing more gaming once that happens. But yeah, cheers for your question, Russ, and good luck. So that is it for the Q&A, guys. I will put everybody's name in a hat, and we'll pull a name out and we'll see who's won the PS2. So see you in a sec. Hi guys, I'm here with Finley, Finley Retro. Say hi Finley to everybody. Say hello.
Hello.
And Finley's going to pick a name out of the hat and we'll see who's won the PS2 bundle. So Finn, you want to pick a name out of the hat here? Any name? There we go. Just one name. Oh, thank you. So we have Mr. Tim, Bad UK. Well done, mate. You won a PS2, so PM your address and that's on its way to you. So cheers, guys. So bye, Finn.
Bye, Finn.